Hello everybody, Dr. Carlo Ojed, emergency physician. In this video, I'm gonna talk about something that's kind of a little bizarre, a little zebra. If you're a pre-medical student or medical student, you definitely wanna know this. You eventually will impress a resident, an attending, or even a colleague, okay? It's called chilaiditis. There's a chilaiditis sign and there's a chilaiditis syndrome. Another synonym for the chilaiditis sign is interposition hepatodiaphragmatica, subphrenic displacement of the colon, subphrenic interposition syndrome, and pseudo pneumoperitoneum. Chilaiditis sign is named after the Greek radiologist Dimitrios Chilaiditi, born in 1883, who first described it when he was working in Vienna in 1910. Little history for you all. It's pronounced chilaiditi, and I'm probably not saying it right, but the important thing is that you know what it is. It refers to the usually asymptomatic interposition of the bowel, usually at the hepatic flexure of the colon between the liver and the right hemidiaphragm. It's seen only in 0.1 to 0.25% of all chest x-rays, and most frequently is an incidental finding. More often in males, almost always in adults, and may be present intermittently. Factors contributing to its occurrence, or to make it more obvious, is the absence of normal suspensory ligaments of the transverse colon, that's a permanent thing, abnormality or absence of the falciform ligament, a redundant colon, as might be seen with chronic constipation or in bedridden individuals, aerophagia, which is swallowing air, paralysis or eventration of the right hemidiaphragm, and patients with chronic lung disease, cirrhosis, and ascites. The sign refers to the usually asymptomatic presence of this interposed bowel. The syndrome may involve actual abdominal pain, constipation, vomiting, even respiratory distress, and anorexia. Imaging findings of chilaiditis syndrome is important because it can simulate pneumoperitoneum, so you end up doing a very expensive and costly CAT scan for something that's totally benign. Look for the presence of haustra folds within the bowel, which can establish the air beneath the diaphragm is actually contained within the large bowel and not just free-floating. A left lateral decubitus abdominal film may be helped to make this difference because you can see that left border a lot better. Concomitant pneumoperitoneum may be more difficult to diagnose, so if there's doubt because the patient has severe abdominal pain or peritonitis, then you have to do an abdominal CT scan. Here's an x-ray of a patient with the syndrome. Go ahead and take a minute to pause and look over it. The main thing there is in the left lower bottom of the screen or the right upper quadrant of the patient's abdomen, but you can also see on the left lower abdomen too. There is interposition of the colon between the right hemidiaphragm and the liver, producing this crescentic lucency in the right upper quadrant like that big white arrow shows. That can be mistaken for free air. Look at this film, it's a zoomed in picture of the same area. Now you can see there the haustra folds inside this lucency, the blue arrows, to help establish that the air is indeed inside the colon. Now this is another patient with very, very significant quote-unquote free air under the diaphragm on the right. You can see clearly, now that you know to look for those haustra folds, that this is just an interposed large bowel underneath the diaphragm. But look at the left, you would think, oh my God, look at all that air under the left diaphragm. Well, that's actually air in the stomach, but most people know that stomach because it's nice and round looking and it's got an air fluid level. And this is actually my patient today that kind of triggered me to go ahead and make this video. This patient came with lung cancer and shortness of breath and fever. And look at where my finger is. That right there is air under the diaphragm. So you would think, oh God, my goodness, that's pneumoperitoneum. He has an infection in his abdomen. But you can see the haustra folds. And this, he's had a previous x-ray that shows the same thing. So it's a chronic finding. And we're not worried about spontaneous pneumoperitoneum. I hope you take some time to learn this. Believe me, you learn this now, you're going to impress a colleague, you're going to impress another medical student, an attending, on an interview with another doctor. You're going to be a smart cookie, all right? So chilaiditis syndrome. Enjoy.